There are some celebrity dramas that resurface even when it seems that everyone was done with them. The one between Kanye West and Taylor Swift is actually one of the most iconic feuds in pop culture. It seemed that their conflict died in 2016 and that Taylor was in the wrong, but just recently new evidence was leaked. So was Taylor the one who was right all this time? Did Kim and Kanye lie to her and to us? Keep watching to find out how Kim and Kanye West manipulated everyone and who's the snake now. But first, remember to subscribe to our channel and turn on the notifications to not miss any of our videos. Now let's get into this. Taylor Swift and Kanye West are of those types of artists that you either love or hate, but whatever your feelings toward them are, there's no doubt that the two are pop culture icons. Their equally iconic beef has been going on for like 11 years, and at one moment they even made up, only to fall out again. But that inspired Taylor's reputation era, so it's fine. The whole drama has been buried for a few years. It seemed that the victory was on Kim and Kanye's side while everyone blamed Taylor for playing the victim in every drama she finds herself in. But this time, with the new evidence that has just surfaced, it turns out that she actually may have really been the victim. You may be thinking that Taylor has just recently been in the news for some drama, so has it been buried for a few years? Well, just to make things clear, that's a completely different feud. That one involves Scooter Braun and the rights to Taylor's music. And this one included a lot of snake emojis, lies, and Kanye's song Famous. And way before that, there was a crashed acceptance speech at an award show. So before I tell you how big the lies were, let's have a reminder of the whole saga that is the feud between Taylor and Kanye. It was the year 2009, and the MTV Video Music Awards, when probably one of the most legendary moments in pop culture took place. So the then 19-year-old Taylor Swift won the Best Female Video category and beat Beyoncé. Kanye West, who was at the award show, didn't like that and jumped on stage when Taylor was collecting her award and interrupted her in the middle of her speech. He said, "Yo Taylor, I'm really happy for you. I'ma let you finish, but Beyoncé had one of the best videos of all time." How rude and awkward was that? Even Beyoncé felt uncomfortable, and when she was picking up another award, she invited Taylor on stage so that she could have her moment. And even Barack Obama didn't like what Kanye did and called him a jackass. The rapper apologized and Swift accepted, as she revealed to ABC Radio in 2009. But then, the following year, Taylor released a song titled Innocent, in which she referenced Kanye. After that, according to the BBC, Kanye took his apology back and accused Taylor of using the VMA's moment as a publicity stunt. Then, in a 2013 interview with the New York Times, Kanye said that he apologized in the first place only because of peer pressure. The drama died down for a few years, and in 2015, it even seemed that Taylor and Kanye made up. It's because at that year's MTV VMAs, the rapper, Kim Kardashian, and Taylor were pictured hugging. They even sparked rumors of a possible collaboration, but Taylor denied that in her interview with Vanity Fair. And with all the other things, she said she had no idea how things would turn around. She basically said that she and Kanye weren't ready to be friends until they had mutual respect for each other. But at that point, she really liked Kanye as a person, and that was a good first step for them. Taylor even presented Kanye with MTV's Video Vanguard Award in 2015. In her speech, she said that the world knew about their infamous encounter at the VMAs, but Taylor actually was a fan of Kanye for as long as she could remember, and she admired his creativity in all areas. She ended her speech saying to all the winners that night, "I'm happy for you, and I'ma let you finish, but Kanye West has had one of the greatest careers of all time." In return, Kanye sent Taylor a huge basket of flowers. Do you think their brief friendship was genuine? Or maybe it was just mutual respect as two of the biggest artists in the industry? I said that their friendship was brief because everything went downhill in 2016. And that's the part of the saga that the recently leaked phone calls refer to. Well, at his Yeezy show in February 2016, Kanye debuted his song titled Famous, which includes a dig at Taylor. The lyrics go, "I feel like me and Taylor might still have sex. Why? I made that bitch famous." Obviously, the song caused massive backlash, and the rapper was criticized for disrespecting Taylor. But he responded saying that he had had an hour-long conversation with the singer and she gave him her permission to name-drop her. Taylor's representatives released a statement saying that she'd warned him about releasing a song with such a strong misogynistic message, and she hadn't been told about the actual line with the B word. What's more, they claimed that Kanye never called to ask for her approval, but to ask Taylor to release his single on her Twitter account. After that, people started picking sides. In turn, Taylor shaded Kanye in her Grammy acceptance speech, saying that there are going to be people who will try to take credit for your accomplishments or your fame. After that, the drama died down for a few months. But in July 2016, while talking to GQ, Kim Kardashian said that Swift approved the lyrics and then completely changed her mind once the track was released. Kim was obviously defending her husband, saying that he always gets so much hate, even when he tries to do things according to protocol and asks for permission. That's when Kim mentioned that the phone call between Kanye and Taylor had been recorded as evidence, and she claimed that Swift's lawyers told them to destroy it. Then, as if Taylor hadn't had enough, Kanye dropped the video to Famous, which featured a naked wax figure of her. The Kardashians, of course, included the feud in their reality show. Kim explained to Courtney why she always felt the need to defend her husband, and it's because people always attacked him, and Taylor played the victim for publicity. She also claimed that Taylor helped Kanye rewrite the lyrics, and their version of events definitely was the truth. She even asked momager Chris for advice, but in the end, Kim didn't take it. Instead, immediately after that episode of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, on her Snapchat, Kim released the footage of the phone call between Swift and West. Besides that, she branded Taylor a snake, which basically became like a symbol of the drama and Taylor's next era. But what was on the recording, which, as it now turns out, was edited? In the footage, you can hear how Kanye reads Taylor the lyric about sex, to which Taylor responds that it's like a compliment. Then the rapper said that he cared about Swift as a person and as a friend, and he thanked her for being so cool about the whole thing. She said her thank yous and how she appreciated that he told her about it before the song came out. Why did Kim feel the need to get involved in the feud? A source told Paper Magazine that Kim was very protective of her husband, and she couldn't stand the fact that he's misunderstood and people thought he was a liar. Isn't she just a great wife? Taylor's reps responded to the recording, saying that Taylor was never told of the other line with the B word. And to be honest, according to the footage, it's true. But the internet sided with the reality star, and hashtag KimExposeTaylorParty started trending on Twitter. Well, Taylor had enough, and responded to Kim's video with a post on Instagram. She said that the video where Kanye was telling her about the other line in the song didn't exist because it never happened. Apparently, he promised to play the song for her, but he never did. In the end, she was falsely painted as a liar when she was never given the full story. Then, Taylor decided to use the whole situation as an inspiration for her next album, Reputation. In her track, Look What You Made Me Do, she took multiple shots at the whole feud, featuring snakes, piles of naked bodies, and, obviously, lyrics. Back then, no one really knew what the truth was, even though the evidence was in favor of Kim and Kanye. But now we got another side of the story. Was someone this bored during self-isolation or what? Because when you went on Twitter on March 21st, hashtag Kanye West is over and hashtag Taylor told the truth were trending. It turns out that someone leaked the full recording of the phone conversation between Kanye and Taylor. So the part leaked by Kim a few years ago wasn't exactly the full story. When you listen to the new full recording, you can hear Taylor saying that she's fine with the original line about sex. She also told the rapper to tell the story the way it happened to him when he mentions that he's going to say, "I made her famous." But isn't something missing? Kanye didn't say that he's going to use the word bitch, which later Taylor was upset with. The thing is that earlier in the recording, when the rapper was telling her that he wrote some controversial lyrics about her, Swift was relieved that it wasn't something like stupid dumb bitch, because that would have been mean. And she also did ask to hear the song. So who's the snake and the liar then? Was it just miscommunication between the artists? During the 25-minute conversation, Kanye got cautious approval for the general concept of both lines, the one about sex and about making her famous. Taylor acknowledged how ironic the first line was, which, by the way, Kanye compared to something controversial that Eminem would say. With the second line, Swift approved of it even though what is said wasn't true because she'd already sold millions of albums before the infamous VMAs moment. So it's not surprising that Taylor was later upset, because she gave a green light to the specific lines she heard, and earlier she hinted that she wouldn't be okay with the rapper using the B-word because that's mean. Did Taylor have the right to be offended? Absolutely. To Kanye, that word was a term of endearment in hip-hop. Meanwhile, to Swift, it's an insult. So he simply could have asked her if she would have been okay with such a change in the lyrics, and maybe we could have avoided years of pointless drama and who knows where we'd be today. What do you guys think of this whole feud? Do you believe that Taylor had the right to be offended? Who do you think is the victim now? Let's talk about it in the comments, and don't forget to share the video with your friends. Remember to subscribe to Curiosips to not miss our new content, and leave a thumbs up. Until next time.